We're going to work on Osoto Gari to start with. And Osoto first on Tori Suzuki, and then move toward her. Move toward her. What happens in a simple moving situation? I want to apply Osoto Gari. The major problem is if I take this big jump back to my Osoto, she moves back further. She runs away from me. She's not going to let me. Or if I can't shake her body so that I can't get there. I don't want to try and throw across the front of the body. I need to be out of your sight to do also guard effectively. So how do you solve the problem? The answer is you slow down. You're working too hard. As you move, you want to control the situation and set a gait and a rhythm. So then as you move back toward her again, what you do is you lag. You just slow yourself slightly. Wait long enough for her to actually commit to her step. And in that moment she's stepping down, she can't also be stepping up. She can't be raising the foot, but she's putting it down. She's got to pick one. She's fully committed. So what you do is you wait for she steps down and you just lag her. And she can't get off the foot fast enough. You can keep her walking out there. It's that simple. She always outruns you because you keep trying to go faster and faster. Don't chase. Solve the problem before it occurs. So you step and you follow. She steps. Yeah. And you turn. So that you just got to delay enough so that she makes the commitment. And she's stuck. She's going to wonder how come she can't get out her foot. Why can't she get away from you? Because you just did that and you nailed it. It's a timing. Okay, let's try it. We have everybody start with that and that. The department is facing the department, you're going to look on it, go down, and try to do like this. Here. Set it up and do that. Look down the other end, and then we'll come back and the department takes it from the back.
Hey.
Let her do it.